tell us about your thesis. What is climate restoration?
Well, climate restoration is very interesting. It's the goal of restoring a climate that humans have actually survived long term. And so it's much more radical than the conventional thinking of trying to reduce the damage. It's the engineering idea of we want to restore what works for human beings. Well, and it turns out that we have the technology and the finance to do it. We just need to start talking about it because we've been talking about a much worse goal.
What's interesting is I've never heard of this technology that you argue we have right now. Ocean pasture restoration, for example, synthetic limestone manufacture, seaweed permaculture, and methane oxidation. These are the four technologies you say that can help us get us there. Let's start with ocean pasture restoration. How does it work?
Yeah, so the four methods, first of all, the reason that you haven't heard about them is that we haven't had a goal of restoring the climate yet. These have all been around for quite a while. Ocean pasture restoration, also called ocean iron fertilization, it is the same process that nature uses to cool the planet before ice ages. And so nature removes a trillion tons of CO2 before or each ice age. There have been 10 in the last million years. And we know how to do the same thing. And the idea is, you know, we all know that photosynthesis, like trees, absorbs CO2. But the trouble with trees, of course, is that they end up dying after a few decades and the carbon goes back into the air when the trees rot. In the ocean, when plants grow, they sink. And so, and then there's no oxygen in the deep ocean. And so they take the carbon with them as they, and of course, a lot of the plants are eaten by fish and all the detritus sinks into the deep ocean. And as I said, that's how nature cooled the planet for our ice ages. And so the way this operates is, and it was tested 10 years ago. It was tested also by Mount Pinatubo 30 years ago. It's localized and it's intermittent. So you do it, they do it in eddies, which are about 100 miles in diameter in the ocean. And the eddy contains the iron. The iron is a phenomenally small amount. It's like 1/100 of a teaspoon per square meter. And within days, it turns green from blue. Blue is beautiful, but it's not green. Green is where you have photosynthesis. And then within another week or so, fish start coming in and feeding on their on the luncheon counter there. And off you go. When it was tested, they were told that they sequestered 100 million tons of CO2.
Peter, before the break, we were going through some of the technologies that you outline in your new book. I want to continue with that and talk seaweed permaculture and exactly what it is and how it gets carbon out of the ecosystem.
Yeah, seaweed permaculture is a variation on the iron fertilization. So, as I said, the important thing in the ocean is when you grow plants, when they die, they sink where there's no oxygen and the oxygen stays out. And with seaweed permaculture, the nutrients that are missing are brought up from the deep ocean in a large pipe, solar powered, takes very, very little energy. And then the seaweed grows. Some of the seaweed is used, is actually harvested and sold for product, some of which sell for $1,000 a ton. Probably half the seaweed ends up falling deep into the ocean. Some of it cut, some of it just naturally falling. And it's fairly simple. The difficulty is they build a structure that the kelp grows on, and that takes some technology. But just like the iron fertilization, it's a commercial product.
Right.
And so it pays for itself.
Hey, Peter, you said it's a commercial product. Let's talk and end there, because I'm wondering if this is so effective, where's the money in it? And I ask that in the question, not in a cynical way, but in a way that motivates companies to do this, to make sure that we have a future.
Yes, it's an interesting challenge because we have the four pathways, and they're all self-financing. And this is the same model that put a CO2 into the air. That is, we had companies selling us heat and energy, which had a byproduct of putting CO2 up. With these four products, the seaweed, the limestone, the ocean fertilization, which leads to fish, mm-hmm. you get product which has a byproduct of pulling CO2 out.
Right.
Now, the challenge is, and this is something that we're dealing with right now,
right.
is that we're afraid to list these on the open market because the customers are going to say, wait a minute, my retirement depends on it. And so we want to make sure that people doing this are primarily interested in restoring the climate for our children and grandchildren,
right.
but only secondarily interested in making money.
Well, it almost sounds like you got to have governments involved who recognize these methods and before it gets too late. Peter Fikowsky, thank you so much. Founder and Chairman Emeritus at Foundation for Climate Restoration. Check out his book that has got the title of Climate Restoration in it.